Hello dear students, in this video I am going to continue the next part of human reproduction. It is about structure of sperm. So in the previous video I explained about spermatogenesis. It is a type of the gametogenesis which occurs in the male gonads called testis. The site of spermatogenesis is seminiferous tubules of the testis. It is initiated by male germ cells called spermatogonial cell. The single spermatogonium, which is a diploid cell, it undergoes spermatogenesis. It divides by mitosis and increases the number. The one spermatogonium continues the next step of spermatogenesis. It enlarges its size. It is a diploid structure referred as the primary spermatocyte. The primary spermatocyte divides by meiosis. After first meiotic division, it produces two haploid cells called the secondary spermatocytes. The number of chromosomes in the secondary spermatocyte is 23, because primary spermatocyte contains 46 chromosomes, which is a diploid number, and secondary spermatocytes are haploid and they contain 23 chromosomes. Both the secondary spermatocytes, they undergo second meiotic division and gives rise to the formation of four haploid cells called the spermatids. But spermatids are not the actual sperms. They undergo modification. They get transformed into actual sperms. The process is called spermiogenesis. So today let us go for structure of the sperm in case of humans. Sperm is male gamete, which is product of spermatogenesis and produced inside the seminiferous tubules of testis. The sperm is haploid male gamete. It is produced in the seminiferous tubules of testis, and the sperms are released from the seminiferous tubule. The process is called spermiation. What are the parts of mature sperm? Sperm is microscopic structure and it consists of the specific parts: head, neck, middle piece and tail. These are the parts of mature sperm. The sperms are microscopic structure. The sperm consists of three important parts: head, neck, middle piece and tail. The entire sperm is covered by plasma membrane. Here in the image you can see the complete sperm is covered by the plasma membrane. Entire sperm is covered by plasma membrane. Here it is a head. This is neck. Below the neck, middle piece is present and it is continued with tail. These are the four parts with respect to structure of a sperm. Then, what is the importance of these parts and what are the other structures of mature sperm? Head portion of the sperm contains an elongated haploid nucleus. This is very important. In the image also you can see that head of the sperm contains haploid elongated nucleus. Anterior portion of the head is covered by a cap like structure called acrosome. Remember, this acrosome is produced from Golgi complex. Acrosome is considered as The largest lysosome. Lysosomes are produced from Golgi complex. Acrosome is also a lysosome of large size and it provides protection to the sperm head. The anterior portion of the sperm head is covered by a cap-like structure called acrosome. What is the importance of acrosome? Acrosome is filled with enzymes that help in fertilization of the ovum. Ovum is nothing but egg. Egg is surrounded by some additional protective coverings, and those protective coverings are broken or lysed with the help of the enzymes of the acrosome at the time of fertilization. Both the terms are very important and both of them are one mark questions. What is acrosome? The anterior portion of the sperm head is covered by a cap-like structure called acrosome. Acrosome, what is the function? What is the importance of acrosome? Acrosome is filled with enzymes that help in the fertilization of ovum. Then next part is middle piece. It contains numerous mitochondria. Here you can see in the image. Around the middle piece, the mitochondrial sheath is present. It is surrounded by mitochondrial sheath. So if we compare this structure, the refill of ball pen, imagine the refill as middle piece, and the spring around that refill you can compare with the mitochondrial sheath. The middle piece, it contains a mitochondrial sheath, and wherever mitochondria is present, it provides the energy, and that energy is used in the movement of sperm tail, because motility of the sperm requires energy, and that energy is provided by mitochondria present around the middle piece. This is important for the motility of the sperm, which is essential once again for fertilization. If the sperm does not reach the egg even after insemination, after the transfer of semen into the female reproductive tract, if the sperms are immotile, then they will not come in contact with the egg. There is no chance of fertilization. Therefore, for the movement of tail, for the motility of the sperms, the energy is required, and that energy is provided by mitochondria present around the middle piece of sperm. So these are the terms that you need to remember with respect to structure of the sperm. Again, I would like to remind here, this diagram is also very important and it is 3-mark question. Along with explanation, the structure of the sperm will be 5-mark question. If diagram is alone asked, it is 3-mark question, an important diagram in the chapter Human Reproduction. Make the practice of this diagram also. I hope it is clear. Thank you.